Hello everyone, welcome to What's New with Keysight X-Series Applications. We'll cover new features and updates on 5G new radio. 3D trace combines error vector time, error vector spectrum, detected allocations in one trace. Channel color customization helps you easily identify results on resource allocation. Simultaneous power measurements in modulation analysis is available now. And more features. So, let's get started. For power reference enhancements, we take second one as example. In Signal Studio, let's pick test model 1.1 for each carrier. Then, four non-contiguous carriers waveform is generated. Good news to let you know, we have a new signal generation software called PathWave Signal Generation. It supports import Signal Studio setting file. In XApp, you can record this new setting file as well. Based on CC summary results, four non-contiguous carriers were demodulated correctly. CC for all window supports you quick action on changing component carrier in each results window simultaneously. Avoid pressing auto scale for each restart measurement. Enable auto scale at restart will save your time on results display. It is complicated to analyze multiple channels on resource allocation at the same time. XApp provides display result or not option for you. As we can see, we can only show PDSCH 1 channel or PDCCH channel. What's more, you can modify channel color to make results display more clearly. Here, we change PDCCH color from yellow to orange. And we can reset all colors to default. Advanced Acquisition Table is available now, helps you easily adjusting RF settings in multiple CCKs. Now, let's go to ACP measurement. Power reference, left and right sub-blocks is added. As we can see, CC0 is sub-block 1, CC1 to CC3 is in sub-block 2. ACP test result is passed. Advanced preset parameters gives you quick settings option. Periodic trigger settings are available as well. After applying preset to all CC, all limit test settings are automatically configured according to 3GPP specifications. Next, let's go to SEM measurement. Aggregated channel bandwidth, left and right sub-blocks are added in power reference. As we can see, SEM measurement result is passed as well. Most importantly, now change acquisition mode to simultaneous. All power measurements we mentioned above can be done in modulation analysis. Because power measurements test settings in each power measurement are shared with modulation analysis, so no further configuration here, just enable each power measurement state. As we can see, power measurement trace and the results table are available as well. Optimize EVM is an immediate action to give you best EVM. As we can see, EVM is changing from 2.0 to 0.18. Next, let's look at intra-cell guard band in uplink case. Config guard band size 73, starts from 100, bandwidth is divided into 2 RB sets. PDSCH slot 10, symbol from 10 to 11, RB set index 1, generate signal. In XAP, intra-cell guard band settings are available now. As we can see, 2 RB sets now same as Signal Studio. Let's check PDSCH settings. RB set index is 1. Every demodulation settings are configured correctly. Good EVM results. Let's put marker on detected allocations. PDSCH detected allocation is correct. symbol 150 equals slot 10, symbol 10. And we can also get resource element power in 3D trace. Next, let's look at PDSCH mapping type B case. In Signal Studio, config SSB half frame index 1 here. PDSCH. Pick mapping type B, along with 4 coexisted LTE CRS channels as well, to test dynamic sharing spectrum case. In XApp, record Signal Studio setting file. As we can see, settings of LTE coexistence here is correct. In SSB, feature half frame index 1 is added now. In PDSCH, mapping type B is available. Now, let's check out EVM results in slot summary. Everything looks good here. Then, add marker to detected allocations for PDSCH. And we can check detected allocation for SSB as well. Put marker for it. From results, we can see SSB in half frame index 1 PDSCH with mapping type B is demodulated correctly. Next, let's take a look at what's new for PRACH. In Signal Studio, config timing information in PRACH burst table. Generate the signal. In XApp, record setting file and signal recording file. As we can see, good EVM and demodulation is correct here. Let's take a look at PRACH channel settings. As we can see, new timing settings are available here. Enable auto detector for PRACH. Timing information and preamble ID can be detected. Results are provided in detector summary and the user summary table. XApp supports wide range of Keysight signal analyzers. For more information, please go to keysight.com. Thanks for watching.